That's a big dark caddis.
So trouty, though. Yes.
The fly pattern I'm tying today is the Elkhair caddis fly. This fly was originally designed by a Altroth in the hills of eastern Pennsylvania back in 1957. It is probably one of the go-to standard dry flies that everybody must have in their box. I'm making a few variations to it. I'm adding a grizzly hackle where there was a ginger hackle in his original design. I'm using deer hair that's in a tan color as opposed to the white elk hair that Al used in his original design. And I'm not using a rib. These are just my variations based upon what it is I'm trying to think about on my stream. Caddis flies are found throughout the world. They're great barometers as to the health of a stream, pond, lake, or river. They are good indicators that it's cold, clean water. They come in many different sizes and many different colors. What you want to do is, in my case anyway, I'm tying this on a size 14, but I'm going to have several 14, 16, 18, 20 patterns for olive, green, black, and tan in my box heading into this upcoming season. So you never know which is going to be happening at any particular time, but that covers the granny apple, the dark caddis hatch, etc. I'm just covering my bases. Caddis spend their first part of their life on the bottom. They either create cases out of sticks and rocks, or some are free living. The footage at the beginning of this video is of a case caddis crawling across the bottom underwater. If you take a look at it, the behavior of a caddis when they rise to the surface, they shed their shell and they're off immediately. And because of that, you'll see a lot of splashy rises. Chances are, if you see a splashy rise on your water, it's a caddis hatch. They don't spend any time on the surface, and because of that, the trout are desperate to get them before they take off. So that's a key factor. If you see a splashy rise, chances are it's caddis. They also fly erratic. They skitter across the top of the water, so it's not as necessary to have the perfect drift when presenting the fly. You can actually manipulate it to skitter it, put a little action on it, bring it under the surface into the film, and you can get away with it. That's a nice luxury to have. And it's not like the mayfly hatch where you have to be really perfect and have it match the flow, etc. The adults fly into the bushes where they mate. They then return to the water and lay their eggs. Sometimes they dive down to the bottom to lay their eggs. In many cases, there'll be a lot of feeding activity along the banks where the caddis will hop down onto sticks or branches. And then use those as a platform to dive back into the water. So focus on the edges of the banks when the caddis are around, because a lot of times they'll be in those bushes and the trout know it. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this pattern, and thanks for watching.
Baptized me one fine day down at the river's edge. All my sins are washed away like water under the bridge. And I had a little girl and her eyes were blue. She lived just over the ridge. The love ran deep and her love ran true like water under the bridge. Sailing away on a paper boat as far as I can go. All the way to New Orleans and the Gulf of Mexico. I the river run clean and the river run rough sometimes. The river run wild and it runs serene, just like a friend of mine. Gonna tie my troubles in a gunny sack, throw them over the edge, sailing away and I won't be back like water under the bridge. Sailing away on a paper boat as far as I can go, all the way to New Orleans and the Gulf of Mexico. Now, you might be saint, you might be sinner, you might be Billy the Kid, you might crap out or roll a winner, it's water under the bridge. I am sailing away on a paper boat as far as I can go, all the way to New Orleans and the Gulf of Mexico, all the way to New Orleans. Sailing away on a paper boat as far as I can go.